boss shut down a brand new pub after hearing a customer swear?
Huh?
Wait,
it's what? A bar, right?
Was it because they only source from like monkeries?
Is it
a monk monasteries?
Monkery.
The guy that opened the bar shut down the bar.
He opened it and it said, "Nope, no cussing in my space."
Oh no, f bombs here.
Mm-hmm. Only
and out of all places, a bar.
No, this guy should really subscribe so he can loosen up.
So he can learn. He should drink his own product.
Yeah, does he even drink?
Chill.
He did drink one pint when he went in.
He did go in for a pint.
Oh, maybe he should stop drinking then.
Maybe it was O'Doul's.
How do you say, like, you overhear the joke and he's like, "That's it, we're everybody out."
Maybe he was drinking. He goes, "I've had it all."
And it like all the
everybody get out of here.
Maybe he was looking for a reason. You know how when you're PMSing and you're just waiting like a release of this anger that you're like, "I don't have anything to be angry about, but I'm so angry." And then like, you know, Steve will just like forget to empty the dishwasher or something. Like, "I got it."
The brain prefers pain to boredom, scientifically.
Ah.
So if you're bored in a relationship, you'll find reasons to pick fights.
Oh, I'm not bored. My PMS just needs to come out. And I'm like, and then I go, "So sorry. Not my, I'm sorry. I'm a bitch right now. I'm sorry."
You get your PMS.
At least you
test.
Say that part.
Yeah, yeah.
That's good.
But I like need to get it out first. I'm like, "Don't do that for these guys ever hate." And then I'm like, "I'm so sorry."
So that means we could.
It's time of the month. I'm sorry.
We could beat our lovers as long as we say sorry afterwards.
Aww.
That's the rule.
No, Joe.
Yes.
No.
Why do you gotta go to beating? You need
why
a hug.
You gotta go there?
Whoa, that's the same
we
thing.
We were having a good, fun time.
Boo! Abuse session.
Boo. You guys suck at joking.
Put the net.
Oh, nice. You ate it.
It was pretty good.
Touch it in your mouth like a falcon at a Renaissance fair.
Wow!
I don't know how I feel about a white person throwing Japanese snacks at a Japanese man.
Weird, but I just don't know what it was. Yeah. I'm glad you called it out. Yeah, I was like, whoa.
Here's some beef and broccoli, Chinese monkey.
Honestly, I didn't want to say anything because I was.
Why did you just like yield to my command? You should have said, "Did the DNA."
We were scared, you know?
Yeah, because of how scary, what I might do.
Pen went up really low.
I do know a lot of white bloggers.
She's feeding me.
So he's the king in this thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
What kind of king goes,
I think you were the jester.
Yeah, you're the fucking clown, bro.
I'm being fed.
Yeah, jesters get fed if they are funny enough.
It's almost lunchtime.
True. Aww. But anyway.
Nice save.
I'm like a pharaoh that gets fed by the servant.
Well, cool. We're moving on. Great.
Yeah.
A man reports a staggering weight loss after his trainer gets him banned from fast food restaurants.
Ooh.
Oh, that's tight. Oh,
that's cool. Ooh.
That guy went above and beyond, man. Yeah.
He actually did it for free. He coached him in like this whole time and he lost a whole bunch of weight and the coach didn't charge him at all.
He forgot to, huh?
But did you hear about Jordan Syatt? He tried a Big Mac a day for 30 days and he lost 7 pounds.
But it's just one Big
Mono
Mac?
Mono meals.
Though?
I mean, maybe, but I think he ate normally. He just counted his macros and he lost weight.
Oh, because he's counting macros.
He wanted to prove, I don't know exactly what he did, but he wanted to prove that like you can still lose weight on a cheap diet.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Or you could ban yourself from fast food restaurants.
What did he do? Take a crap inside of McDonald's on the floor or something?
No, his trainer banned him.
No, so his.
Well, I mean, like, how did he get banned? Or is it just you're not allowed to go?
So.
What? Because he asks you, because he really wants to know, and you go, and then he goes, "No, but how? Tell me." No, really, I want to know. Like, did he take a shit?
And
you're about
to. And I'm like.
It's like, how's your day? It was good, huh? Yeah, but how was your day? It was pretty good? Oh, okay, yeah.
Yeah, that would be like hours long compilation of every time I try to say something.
Oh my God, someone please make it where Tiff goes,
"Tiff, but no words, just interruption."
Actually, I don't think they'll even see.
Oh, because it doesn't make it past the editing.
I don't think the editor would even include it.
So it looks natural.
I wish you could have so many compilations, like.
That'd be so awesome. I want to see that. Okay, so the way his trainer did it is by sending out flyers to all Dipsy's.
Oh, wow, that guy's big.
His local fast food restaurants, like his favorite fast food restaurants.
Oh, that's awesome.
Voluntarily agreed to this, obviously, yeah. too.
What and size so, shirt is that?
Tent.
That's a big old one.
It's a tent.
Dude, that's like a bed sheet. That's a fucking, that's like a twin size bed.
I got canceled.
Oh no, Nikki, come back. Nikki, do you want to keep that?
Mm-hmm. Do you want to start the apology right now or wait till?
Hey, it's cool. I said it.
Yeah, see, Joe said it.
You guys, fuck it. Just, I said it.
Are you serious, News? Submitted by Littlefinger, the manager of a beer brewing company that is being sued for discrimination claims he didn't know the employee was black.
So he was just saying the N-word over and over again?
Well, no, maybe the employee was wearing a lot of hoodies.
Why? What if he was really black and he doesn't see color? I want to see this guy's picture.
All right, so...
I didn't know he was black.
Did he ever see the employee or did he just see him in apparel?
They were actually friends for, like, even before this employee started working at this brewing company. All right, so this guy, his name is Tracy Evans. This is what he looks like.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
What did the guy think? What? He was Hawaiian or something? I guess he could be Samoan, maybe.
He doesn't look black to me.
I could see him as a Filipino guy, too.
Yeah, like an islander, like some sort of like Hawaiian or Samoan or Filipino.
He was Russian.
He became one of the first employees of color at Founders Brewing Company, which is a pretty popular craft brewery in Grand Rapids, Michigan. And so he started there 6 years ago, but he was saying that over time, well, initially, he was passed over for a promotion.
Oh.
And so a year into his employment, and so this promotion ended up going to two more recently hired employees, both of whom were white. And so Tracy ended up training both of them, but their behavior at the company was very alarming, he says, because one had drunkenly crashed his car into another vehicle, and another employee had allegedly exposed himself to a crowd.
So, like, not employees of the month.
Where the fuck do you find these crazy ass motherfuckers?
And you're saying that at Detroit, though, things didn't get much better because one coworker noticed that the brewery was starting to attract more African American customers and made a comment about the establishment's dark clientele.
Later, it's Detroit. Yeah. What do you expect, you fuckface?
Later, he called one of Detroit's former black mayors, Kwame Kilpatrick. I hope I said that wrong. The head.
I said that wrong.
I hope I said that wrong.
I hope I said that wrong.
You should start saying. No, you owned it. Awesome. You should have just kept it.
Yep. That was so good. Sorry.
This reminds me of this one horrible like, autocorrect. We had a guest, and then he was like, "Hey, thanks for thanks for having me." And then I said it wasn't great having you.
Damn.
Dude, I'm sorry.
Who was it?
Josh Leva.
Damn, Tiffany Del Rose.
He never responded
dude.
After that.
That's fucking funny.
Sorry, dude. Because it was a long ass time before I realized it was an autocorrect, and then I sent that back and I was like, I'm so sorry.
That is fucking hilarious. He just sits there and he's like, oh, god damn.
For hours.
Ah! That's fucking great.
She's like, wow, they're really honest.
Was this after we had him in Danger Boys?
No, it was before.
Before?
Oh. Anyway.
He still came.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's like, I guess I hate myself.
I guess they hate me, but I'm gonna do them a favor today.
Yeah. And do yourself a favor. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel.
Yeah, subscribe.
Mm-hmm. I hope I said that wrong.
I know, dude. It's like, my brain does that sometimes when I want to say right, it says left, and I'm like, no, but I meant right.
All right, bro, I heard your watch, okay?
Anyway, sorry.
A tech firm is looking to pay someone to lend their likeness to a new line of robot assistants.
Oh, never mind. Well, maybe. Give me a lot.
That'd be
That's
cool.
Mine. I'll do it for like $5 million.
Yeah, so this tech firm is looking for the right person to lend their likeness for a new line of robot assistants that they would be assisting the elderly.
And that's scary, bro.
What's the right person? You just have to have a really nice looking face or like...
Yeah, maybe like super neutral, like symmetrical, like...
Yeah, they're friendly. Saying a kind and friendly face.
I'm out.
Welcome.
This RBF is fucking out.
And you know old people are the most racist, so...
They are.
That's true.
Should be a white person?
Well, it depends on what kind of old person it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Some old people don't like white people.
I think it's gotta be an Indian guy. I've never seen a threatening Indian guy in my entire life. They all look very friendly.
What about ethnically ambiguous?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think ethnically like ambiguous. Friendly equals female. I don't think friendly and think of a guy.
I think of female, I think of bitches. You don't think I'm bitches?
You think I'm a bitch?
Didn't you just call yourself an RBF?
Yeah, you know what that stands for?
Yeah.
What does it stand for?
Resting bitch face.
Yeah, but I'm not a bitch.
You guys both fucking swiveled like this. That was funny.